Lord said, I will speak, and he's speaking to us. And he has spoken already. He has given us promises, forgiveness for the sinner. He has given us promises, healing for the sick. He has given us promises, sanctification for the believer. Holiness for the believer, holiness of heart. Holiness in our soul. Holiness in our spirit. Holiness in our relationship. Holiness in our lifestyle. He has given us the promise that he will do it. He's going to do it in Jesus' name. He has given us the promise of deliverance. He has given us the promise of the power of the Holy Ghost. The promise is unto you and to your children, and to them that are far off, even as many as the Lord our God shall call. And then he says over here, I am the Lord, I will speak, and the word that I shall speak shall come to pass. And then he says, it shall be no more prolonged, there will be no delay. For in your days, O rebellious house, when I say the word, I will perform it, says the Lord God. Look at verse 28. Therefore, say unto them, thus says the Lord God, there shall none of my words be delayed, be prolonged anymore. But the word which I have spoken shall be done, says the Lord God. It will happen in Jesus' name. Every word he has given us, all the promises he has given us, what he said he will do, that he will cleanse us and he wash us from all our defilement and from all our impurities, that he'll take everything away, that word will not be delayed, it will be done. That he will take away the stony heart out of our flesh and give us a heart of flesh and make us holy through and through, within and without and round and everywhere, in the church and at home, at the place of work, everywhere we go, that word he has spoken, he'll fulfill it. It will not be prolonged in Jesus' name. That he said the promise of the baptism in the Holy Ghost, he shall receive power after the Holy Ghost has come upon you. Then will become dynamites in the hands of the Lord, battle axe of the Lord. He has given us that word, and that word is going to be fulfilled in Jesus' name. In Luke chapter 1, Luke chapter 1, I'm reading from verse 17. Luke chapter 1, verse 17. As he spake by the mouth of his holy prophets, which have been since the world began, that we should be saved from our enemies and from the hand of all that hate us. He'll deliver us from our enemies. He has given us that word of promise, and it's going to be fulfilled in Jesus' name. Then it says, to perform the mercy promised to our fathers, and to remember his holy covenant, the oath which he swore to our father Abraham, that he will grant unto us, that we've been delivered out of the hand of our enemies, might serve him without, tell me out loud, without fear, in holiness and righteousness before him all the days of our life. That's the promise of the Lord. Holiness unto the Lord. Righteousness before the Lord. And it says all the days of our lives. Holiness in the morning, holiness in the afternoon, holiness in the evening. Holiness at home, holiness at work. Holiness in the church with the brethren. Holiness in the world when the unbelievers are there. Holiness every time and holiness everywhere. That's the promise he has given us. And he has said that that promise will not come to naught in holiness and righteousness before him all the days of our life. And thou child shall be called the prophet of the highest. For thou shalt go before the face of the Lord to prepare his way, to give the knowledge of salvation unto his people by the remission of their sins. The Lord has promised us the forgiveness of sin, the cleansing away of sin, the taking away of sin. And then he has given us also the promise that will give that salvation, and that salvation will come to our children, will come to everybody around us. And it says, through the tender mercies of our God, whereby the day spring from on high has visited us to give the light, to give light to them that sit in darkness and in the shadow of death, to guide our feet into the way of peace. He'll do it in Jesus' name. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5. I'm reading from verse 22. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 22. Abstain from all appearance of evil. Is that possible? I said, is that possible? Even an appearance of evil will not be attached to our life this year in Jesus' name. And the very God of peace sanctify you how? Wholly, entirely, completely. And I pray, God, your whole spirit and soul and body be preserved blameless until the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Faithful is he that calleth you, who also will do it. He'll do it for us this year in Jesus' name. Numbers chapter 23. Numbers chapter 23. I'm reading from verse 19. Numbers chapter 23. And we're reading from verse 19. God is not a man that he shall lie, neither the son of man that he shall repent. As he said, and shall he not do it? As he spoken, and shall he not make it good? Every promise he has given us, he'll make it good this year in our lives in Jesus' name. Behold, I've received commandment to bless, and he has blessed, and I cannot reverse it. No Balaam will reverse the blessing of God in your life. The better things the Lord has promised us, those better things are coming. And they'll be upon every life in Jesus' name. He has not beheld iniquity in Jacob, neither has he seen perverseness in Israel. The Lord is God is with him, and the shout of a king is among them. God brought them out of Egypt, he has brought us out. He has, as it were, the strength of a unicorn. Surely there is no enchantment against Jacob, no curse against your life. No enchantment against your life. And there's no talisman or juju anybody can do against your life in Jesus' name. Surely, without any shadow of doubt, there's no enchantment against Jacob. Neither is there any divination against Israel. According to this time, it shall be said of Jacob and of Israel, what God has wrought. It will be a year of testimony, a year of rejoicing, a year of holiness, a year of happiness, a year of prosperity, a year of a purity, and a year when all our desires are met in Jesus' name. He has done it already. I said he has done it already. Better things have come. Bridled tongue will make you see them. And then the blessed treasure will come upon your life. Let's rise up and talk to the Lord in prayer. It's a year of praying, a year of praying, a year of praying. And we're going to pray that the better things the Lord has promised, that this year will be ours, this year will be yours, and you're going to see blessing just flowing and flowing and flowing into your life. Open your mouth and begin to talk to the Lord. Gracious provision of better things. Gracious provision of better things. Gracious provision of better, better, better things. To be born again, that's better than being sinful. Born again, that's better than being carnal. Born again, that's better than backsliding. Born again, that's the better thing. Sanctified. Sanctified, made holy. Better, better things. What a wonderful thing when the Lord takes away the stony heart out of your flesh and he gives you the heart of flesh. Soft, gentle, pliable, teachable, humble. That's the better thing. Tell the Lord, give me that kind of heart. That kind of heart. That kind of heart. Soft, gentle, pliable, teachable, humble, obedient. That's what he wants to do this year. The power of the Holy Ghost upon your life. You shall receive power after the Holy Ghost has come upon you. And you shall be witnesses unto me both in Jerusalem and Judea and in Samaria and to the uttermost part of the earth. You've been a believer for a long time. You have not been baptized in the Holy Ghost. This is the year of the power of the Holy Ghost in our lives. You've been saved, you have not been sanctified. This is the year of sanctification. It's the year of holiness, the year of purity. Tell the Lord, tell the Lord, the promise of better things. the past years, sick, healed, sick, healed, sick, healed. Not again this year. A year of health, a year of strength, a year when you stay healthy and it makes you whole through and through. Tell the Lord, better things, better things, better things. In the past failure, then you manage to skip through and maybe pass an exam, get a job, barely living, not having enough. But you're telling the Lord this year, it's a year of great provision, a year of abundance, a year of prosperity. And the Lord says He'll open the windows of heaven, that you'll not have room enough to receive, you'll not have room enough to keep what He's going to give you. Tell the Lord, I make it a year of prosperity, a year of abundance, a year of breaking forth, a year of showers of blessing, showers of blessing, showers of blessing, showers of blessing. This is the year. All you have lost, the Lord bringing back into your life. All the lack, the Lord bringing it back to your life. All the limitations of the past, the Lord breaking all that limitation. And things you never saw, things you never received, miracles you never got, the Lord bringing those miracles to your life this year. A year of miracles, signs, and wonders. Tell the Lord. A year of prayer is a year of purity. A year of prayer is a year of power. A year of prayer is a year of passion. A year of prayer is a year of prosperity. A year of prayer is a year of great possibilities. Open your mouth and talk to the Lord in prayer. Saved, praise the Lord. Sanctified, praise the Lord. Healed, praise the Lord. Delivered, praise the Lord. Prospered, praise the Lord. Breakthrough, praise the Lord. Breaking forth, praise the Lord. No famine, no scarcity. Open your mouth and talk to the Lord. That this year, holiness within, holiness without. Holiness at home, holiness in the church, holiness in the office, holiness on the street, holiness in the private, holiness in the public, holiness through and through. Your watchword and lifestyle, holiness. Pray and tell the Lord that the Lord Himself will fulfill His good promises of better things in your life this year. Better things this year. It's a year of boldness, a year of authority, a year of power, a year of resisting the devil, may he flee from you, a year of self-denial, a year of sacrifice, a year of separation unto the Lord, a year of sanctification, sanctification. Holiness of heart, holiness of life, a year of patience, a year of perseverance, offer yourself fully unto the Lord. If you have never given your life to Jesus, can I just tell the Lord now, I give my life to you. I turn away from my sin. I turn to Jesus as my Savior. I receive Jesus now as my Savior. I trust Him. I believe Him. He died for me to take all my sins away, to give me a change of heart in your life. In your heart, a new character, a new conduct, a new behavior. I give myself completely unto Him. I pray that God will make you a new creature with a new face, a new nature, a new life, a new commitment, a new consecration. That your tongue that had been the problem in the past, that your tongue will not stand between you and your blessing this year. Words of anger will not be heard from your mouth. Words of envy, words of jealousy, words of criticism, words of insubordination, words of rudeness will not be found, not be heard in your mouth this year. They bridled their tongue before the walls of Jericho could come down flat. And if you want all those barriers to be broken out of your life, all those walls standing between you and the promised land to break down your life, your tongue must be bridled, controlled. If you want the enemies to be powerless, impotent, Sennacherib and Rabshakeh, not to have any authority over your life or any power over your life this year, you must hold your peace, hold your tongue, bridle your tongue. If you don't want calamities to come on you, evil to come upon you, you must bridle your tongue. You must not play with lying, play with deception. Say you have an answer when you don't have an answer. Say you have problem when you don't have problem. Telling lies for one reason or the other. Telling stories that are not true. To deceive our coordinator, deceive our group coordinator, deceive our overseers, deceive our leaders. Bring calamity upon yourself. Bridle your tongue. Don't allow anybody to put lie in your mouth, story in your mouth, to go and tell our leaders for the ulterior motive to bring a curse upon your life. Pray that the Lord will help you this year, that you'll bridle your tongue, and the blessed treasures of the blessing, of the breakthrough, of the promises, the Lord will bring upon your life. God is not a man that he should lie, neither the Son of Man that he should repent. As he said, shall he not do it? As he spoken, shall he not bring it to pass? Blessings are coming upon your life this year. Get ready. Prepare yourself for the blessing. Your prayer will be your revival. Your prayer will be your showers of blessing. Your prayer will be a year to climb to higher ground. In Jesus' name we pray. And everybody said, yeah. I'm sure you're expecting the blessing. Yeah. And everything you are prayed for, you are believing that the Lord will do it. Yeah. No enemy will stand between you and your blessing this year in Jesus' name. The abundance of the Lord is coming upon your life. Your tongue will now rest. Your tongue will be at peace. And all those talk of past years, everything is under control this year. Let's pray together. Lift up your hand before the Lord. Make it a new year. Make it a new year coming for you. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you because you have promised us better things this new year. And we pray, Lord, the better things will come. Even from this day, those better things will start coming in Jesus' name. We pray, Lord, that our spiritual experiences this year will be better. Our profession of being born again will be better. The presence of the Spirit of God in our lives this year will be better. And the experience of sanctification, holiness, spiritual heart and life will be better this year in Jesus' name. Our evangelism will be better. Touching lives will be better. And now, Lord, the windows of heaven you open, the showers you give unto us, the prosperity you give unto us, the health you give unto us, the believers you give unto us, everything this year will be better in Jesus' name. I'm asking, Lord, according to your promise, wipe away every negative sin out of every life in Jesus' name. We're asking, Lord, that you start from our soul, from our spirit, from our body, and we pray that everything that is negative, everything coming from the devil, everything coming from the enemy, everything coming from you, from a cause, and from any sin of the devil, flush everything out of our lives in Jesus' name. Give us life. Give us life in abundance. And every form of sickness, Lord, I take authority over that sickness now. Get out in Jesus' name. From the top of the head to the soles of the feet, every pain, every virus and every cell that is not right and every kind of incurable disease will come against it. This year is not a year of sickness. This year is not a year of death. This year is not a year of just, you know, an invalid. But this year is a year of being strong, of being healthy. This year is a year when we're going to retain the health of the Lord in our bodies in Jesus' name. Therefore, Lord, touch everyone. Heal everyone. Take sickness away from the midst of your people in Jesus' name. And I pray, Lord, this is our barren. You said, this year, none of us will be barren. And I pray that whatever is risen from that barrenness, take it away in Jesus' name. This is the year of great possibilities in the area of